to my questions. Tell me what happened with Jago, why he left, and tell me why Twisted Jago Hamburger Juice is back in Empire. Why did he leave Finger Cramp? We all need to know. I need to know. Let's hear it.
Okay, so this goes back. This goes back further than everyone even knows. So now that he's out of Finger Cramp, we're gonna open up the juicy files.
Yes.
The stuff that I had to keep secret because I did not want to be unprofessional.
Yes.
So to speak. All right. We're gonna go as far.
Wait. Is this gonna be real rap?
This is gonna be real hamburger juice. That's what this is gonna be.
Yes.
We are gonna go back to East Coast Throwdown.
Ooh.
Last year. So this all started at your event.
Okay, like it so far. Good story. Let's hear it.
I'm gonna try to be as professional, so I'm gonna minus the cursing, but I'm gonna be very as vulgar as possible. So this scumbag hack walks up to Rasan and Dominion and tells them, "Why are you guys loyal to Triforce? What is he doing for you? Why don't you take a trip back to me to New York? I want to talk to you guys, blah, blah, blah." Tries to offer them to leave Empire and go with him. Then the same scumbag walks up to me and says, "Hey, Triforce, we need to sit down and talk some business. I think we could collaboration with Finger Cramp and EMP. So I'm like, "Really? Sure. Not a problem." Andre tells me that Hack wants to do some type of deal where he's Empire, but, you know, Finger Cramp wants to do some type of media production, whatever, and they need the personality, and they would like to license Andre to Finger Cramp. Now, like any business, if you're going to license talent out, it's going to cost money. But I said, I will waive the fee. This is an opportunity for Andre to expand his talents and his personality. Forget it. Go do what you got to do, Andre. So Andre goes, okay. He tells Andre A, Andre tells him B, then it comes back to me a different way. Next thing I know, Andre leaves EMP. So I ask Andre, "Why'd you leave EMP?" And he's like, "Well, I tried to talk to Hack about, you know, being Empire and being in Finger Cramp." And he's like, "I have to make a choice. It's either Finger Cramp or Empire. And since we're not a sponsor, and Hack supposedly is a sponsor, and he's giving Jago a stipend certain amount of money per month, Jago has to go with what's in his best interest." So me and Jago shake hands on that. I said, "If you think this is the best thing for you, fine. Go do what you have to do, and I wish you the best of luck." I told Jago, "Listen, I do not trust Hack. He's just going to try to use you. You're an established player already. You know, you were the first person to chink that invincible armor of Daigo's at season's beatings. You have a funny personality. You and Rasan and Remix be cursing and doing all that nonsense, but he's going to use that to try to build a brand for his media. Be careful." He says, "Don't worry, I got it. Me and Remix got this," because Remix is like, he's not going to leave Empire. He's going to stay Empire, and it's going to be him and Andre working with Finger Cramp. So as long as Remix is still Empire, then Hack can't do much. That's where the whole thing with Remix was like, "This guy stole my shit. Why we hate you?" That belongs to Remix. That does not belong to Hack. I'm like, if you want to get legal about it, obviously it belongs to Hack because he filed for it or whatever, the crap he did or whatever, blah. But the whole idea came from Remix.
Yeah, because I do remember Remix talking bad about them and talking bad about Andre, and I never really asked why, because, you know, I'm just like, whatever. I'll just let him do his thing. So that's kind of why Remix has some beef in there, huh?
Yes, and that's where you had the beef in. So what happened is Andre and Remix got in an argument. Sometimes Nelson will say something to you that kind of stings you and makes you rebuttal. And when you rebuttal, like, he gets mad when you rebuttal just as hard as he does. So, you know, he said something to Andre, and Andre just said, That's why I'm running your show instead." So that's what made Nelson tight. That's what made Nelson tight, because Nelson really, that was like his baby. That was really close to him. So he kind of felt really disrespected by that. And that's how the whole thing with him kicking Andre at the house all started. So we get past that. I don't care about all the nonsense. Those two guys that's their personal issue, whatever. Andre has never said anything negative about me in my face. People go around and say, "Yo, Jago be trashing the Empire," but who doesn't go around trashing the Empire? So unless they don't say, if they don't say it in my face, it's hearsay. That's how I look at it. So then I hear from Andre that Hack and him get into an argument because Andre wanted to go to a tournament and Hack did not want to send him to the tournament. So Andre is like, yo, you got me in here doing all these Why We Hate You videos, and I need to go to these tournaments so I can keep my skills in shape and be a contender in the scene. You're supposed to be a sponsor. If I knew you were going to do this, I would have just stayed in Empire. So Hack told Andre, listen, you will go where I tell you to go because I made you.
Eek.
That's what Hack told Dre. And Dre was like, what? So Dre got really angry about that. So Dre had talked to some people on the low about it to try to vent his anger, because I don't know what he was going to do about it. And it eventually reached me. So I spoke to Dre. And Dre was like, well, what does he do? Because he's under contract. So I said to Dre, unlike other entities that finds ways to manipulate members of Empire Acadia out of the organization, breach any verbal or written agreements that they have with the organization to join them for sponsorship, I told Andre, Empire Acadia will not follow suit in what these heathenous scumbags do.
Heathenous scumbags.
Heathenous scumbags.
My gosh.
If that's a word. So I told Jago, finish out your contract, and when you're done, you are welcome to come back home. So we said, okay. So on August 5th at midnight, the contract ended, and he was gone. It is literally, that's it.
That's it.
That's it. He was gone. Because if you notice, they don't need Jago no more. They got, you know, the greatest thing since Justin Wong, Chris G. So they put Jago on the back burner. And that's not an opinion. That's just the truth. Like, real rap.